Can you guess what I look like just from hearing the sound of my voice? Well, you can probably infer a few things and narrow it down. I'm probably male, not super young or super old, but after that, do you have any guesses? Do you know what my nose looks like, or how big my lips are? Researchers all over the world are working to teach artificial intelligence how to guess these facial features and so much more based off of a voice print of just a few milliseconds. So how good has it gotten? What can it be used for in the future? And why are we even doing it? Don't forget to subscribe if you like this video. Now, listen to this clip and see if you can guess who the actor is.
So I'm going to brighten the mood by telling a few jokes. Try this one on for size. I don't care for cheese. I'm a curmudgeon.
If you're a fan of Brooklyn Nine-Nine, you might have guessed it to be this man, Andre Brower. But if you're speech-to-face AI, a neural network designed by researchers at MIT, you'd have guessed this image. Now, I know what you're thinking. That looks absolutely nothing like Mr. Brower. But speech-to-face did get some stuff right. He's a male, somewhat middle-aged, of a darker complexion, and look at the shape of their noses. The AI nailed this almost perfectly. That's because our nose and the rest of the bones in our face really shape how we sound. Sound begins in the vocal flaps. Their length and width are the big reasons our voices are pitched higher or lower. But then we have to push the sound out. It rattles around in our chest cavity, and while a good deal of it escapes through our mouths, the rest of our face also acts as a sort of megaphone for our voice. It's why some singers feel vibrations in their cheekbones, jaws, and, you guessed it, their noses.
Because of this, the AI can tell with some accuracy the shape of our nose just from hearing the sound of our voice. But the AI doesn't just take facial features into account. It should also be of note that groups that emanate from certain regions tend to have similar attributes. It's one of the reasons why you can tell where somebody's from just from looking at them.
It also means that you or an AI can guess with pretty good certainty what ethnicity someone is just from hearing the sound of their voice.
When it comes to voice biometrics, it's not dependent on language. We really are measuring the characteristics of your voice and how you speak. Nuance took it a step further and created linguistic biometrics, which is identifying you based on how you use vocabulary, based on grammar, based on sentence structure.
Dialect recognition is used in many voice biometric systems. Speech-to-face AIs did this with some success, but it wasn't built to give you a perfect representation of what a person's face would really look like. Instead, it's trying to recover characteristic physical features that are correlated with the input speech.
Which is a fancy way of saying that it's building these drawings based on correlations between speech patterns and facial features.
Researchers fed over a million videos with audio samples to an AI and let it draw the correlations. Sometimes it works really well. Other times it works a little less well. The problem with patterns is that AI ends up having to be kind of stereotypical, and that can lead to objectively wrong images. Like a man with a higher pitched voice might be portrayed as a woman, or as an ethnicity that might not relate to the one he was born into.
Which proves that there are some limitations when it comes to tech like this. But there's still a lot that can be done with it. And when paired with other research, it can be extremely helpful to certain industries.
Over in Pennsylvania, researchers at Carnegie Mellon University have been working on converting audio capture to facial features for over 20 years. Much like MIT's work, their audio capture can guess how a person looks.
But this research is pushed further by also working to guess the environment around a person.
They can do this in a similar way to how echolocation works. After your voice leaves your body, it bounces all around its surroundings and back to you. That can inform the size of the room, but also specifically what the room is comprised of, whether it be a machinery-filled warehouse, a glass cube of an office conference room, or a mostly linoleum room with two windows behind you and wooden floors. It can also be used to infer where that voice is coming from in 3D space, which can be used to decipher height information. Professor Rita Singh, leader of the Carnegie Mellon Research, told the World Economic Forum that this AI could be pushed even further, and it can be used to reveal weight, skull structure, the level of intoxication of a person, and even if that person has a certain disease.
She was able to put her research to the test in 2014, when the US Coast Guard was receiving a high number of prank calls by people seeking rescue that didn't actually need to be saved.
The audio clip she received sounded something like this. Mayday, mayday! Mayday, mayday! From this short clip, she was able to deduce that the man wasn't actually on a boat, but in a warehouse. He was probably a white male around 40 years old and 75 kilograms in weight. He wasn't in any kind of trouble, and he was sitting on a metal chair in a concrete room, among a bunch of other things.
She was able to extrapolate all that information from the same word repeated twice. Whether or not the Coast Guard ever actually caught the person seems to not have been made public, but it's clear they were able to get a pretty good sense of who that person might have been, and most importantly, they were finally able to distinguish which were the real threats and which were the fake ones. Leading voice experts have suggested that, as this technology improves, it could one day be used not just to generate a rough sketch of a face, but to generate a clear 3D portrait of what this person might actually look like.
So it's likely that in the future, this tech could expand to the CSI field. Imagine a world where, instead of having to describe a person's face to get a police sketch, the cops could capture a noise print from the scene of the crime and then generate the exact face of the culprit.
Voice prints are as, if not more unique than fingerprints, and they're already becoming a breakthrough technology for the CSI field.
This won't showcase our creativity, but very early on we realized that a fraudster could record somebody's voice and play it back. So we developed algorithms to detect recordings. That was the cornerstone of our anti-spoofing technology. But we then thought about, okay, well, fraudsters could potentially one day create a fake voice, right? A synthetic voice of you. You know, the media has been full of stories about deep fakes. Back in 2014, we developed an algorithm to detect synthetic voices. So we can actually detect and identify deep fakes, at least the voice component of them.
Nuance has helped out on court cases where detecting a fake video from a real video has been a key piece of evidence in clearing people of crimes they didn't commit. It's also been used to pin people who did commit the crimes by matching their voice prints. But taking a step back from security, let's look at how this can impact the average Joe.
Many institutions like Chase, HSBC, TD Bank, and many more have begun using voice printing as an easy way of securing clients' identities when speaking to them on the phone.
Over the last 12 months, we've been able to account for over $2 billion in fraud loss savings that have been enabled through voice biometrics.
Tech like this is also easier for older people to use. It's already helped over a million people keep from getting scammed. But of course, with technology expanding to such a degree and our voices being recorded frequently without our permission, this does raise the question of what would happen if this tech gets weaponized in a big brothery sort of way.
I think that, you know, the fundamental step for this technology to be well adopted and accepted by consumers is to ensure that there's full transparency. The European Union, they have implemented quite comprehensive regulations and laws around the use of biometric technology, right, that apply to all EU nations. And I wouldn't be surprised, right, if we see similar type of regulation eventually down the road in North America as well.
Though that legislation is not here yet. In the meantime, that might make our voices way more precious. But does that mean that we're actually going to stop using them? Well, seeing as we all readily gave away our fingerprints, iris scans, and face scans to our cell phones, our voice prints might just be the next thing we give away for a convenient method of a security check.
So, what do you think? Would you or do you use voice printing in your everyday life to confirm your identity? Do you think it'd be a cool assist in the CSI field? Let us know in the comments down below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more vids like this one.